Learn about the amazing improvements in SQL Server 2022 related to buffer pool parallel scans this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. We are continuing our SQL Server 2022 series, and I have once again joining me David Pless from the SQL Server team. David, thanks so much for coming on the show again.
Absolutely. Good to be here.
Good to have you back. And in the last episode, we talked about storage engine capabilities in SQL Server 2022. And in this episode, we're going to be diving into a very specific example, I think very exciting example. So without further ado, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Oh, yeah. Buffer pool parallel scan. So let's talk about like the what currently happens, like the current buffer pool scan operations. So in SQL Server 2019 and previous releases, operations that required scanning the buffer pool could appear to be very taxing and slow, especially on large memory machines, such as like the M series SQL Server virtual machine and larger on-prem SQL Server environments. And the impact can be noticed on operations such as like creating a new database, really everything we have on the slide, right? Backup restore, always on failover events, file drop operations, checkdb, checktable, and internal operations like checkpoints. Customers on these larger machines, such as systems that have more than a terabyte of memory, may witness these long database creation operations. In some cases, it can take several minutes to complete even some of the more basic tasks. Even log restore operations could be slower, and availability group failover operations can be impacted as well.
Why on larger machines do we see it to be slow?
So the reason for this overhead is that scanning the buffer pool in SQL Server 2019 and earlier releases is always a serial operation. So even if you have a large machine, that's not going to help you. Actually, the impact would be greater, and it doesn't matter about the size of the operation. All it has to do with the serial operation and the amount of memory that it's having to scan through. So you can even see the impact on creating a net new empty database. And it seems counterintuitive. Why would this issue happen on larger machines? Why would it be slower in a larger box?
Right.
It's because of the serial scan process and the amount of memory that you have to address regarding the buffer pool. So in the documentation, when it talks about a workaround, we state that there's no way to eliminate this issue in the documentation currently, 2019 and prior. And flushing the buffer pool is going to result in some degree of performance degradation. So any subsequent query executions would have to reread the data from the data file. So now you're increasing I/O if you try to implement a workaround, like let's say flushing the buffer pool.
Got it. So I'm hoping you're coming on to tell us something new and exciting in 2022
Yes.
that's going to fix this.
Right. So certainly a problem if you have a large machine and you're dealing with that. Right. So in SQL Server 2022, the buffer pool parallel scan feature improves the performance of these scan operations on these larger machines by utilizing multiple CPU cores. And so customers running SQL Server 2022 may see over 20 times improvement in executions, which were previously slower due to these serialized scan operations, right? So this parallel scan feature also improves the buffer pool scan performance of smaller databases residing on larger machines. Again, the improvement is adding processing power to scan the buffer pool more efficiently. So smaller operations on large machines will also benefit. And this is a general benefit. So just by upgrading to SQL Server 2022, you're going to see this benefit because it's on by default. And we've also backported some of the buffer pool scan telemetry for supportability. We'll get into that as well. So like, being able to see long scans in the error log starting in SQL Server 2016 SP3 and more details that can be captured using various extended events, extended events for like scanning, start, complete, capturing error events, flush cache operations, all of that will be available. And so in the next slide, I'll have some context on this. Okay. So As you can see, we've added some diagnostics to improve the supportability experience for both serial and parallel buffer pool scans. The events in bold are already available in SQL Server 2016 SP3. The other events in the debug channel specifically support buffer pool events for SQL Server 2022. But the main event to focus on is the buffer pool scan complete event, which is fired when a buffer pool scan takes longer than a second to complete. And that event is going to give you your elapsed time, parallel tasks, the number of scanned buffers, the command, and the operation. Also, the new diagnostics will provide error log messages whenever a buffer pool scan takes longer than 10 seconds to complete. Again, the error log message has been backported and is available in SQL Server 2016 SP3. It's a good piece of information to track when you're looking to start collecting data on just one of the benefits of migrating to SQL Server 2022.
Right. And so just to clarify, the bold extended events are going to be available, or all the extended events? And I can start using those so I can see, like, hey, this is how much time I could save if I move and get the benefits.
Right. So the ones in bold that you'll have, the error log you're going to have. And this is this was backported to SQL Server 2016 SP3 and up.
Awesome.
So you can start collecting this data to get an idea. I mean, of course, there's a ton of improvements in SQL Server 2022. But just for, hey, will buffer pool parallel scan help me on this larger data warehouse machine, this larger mission critical transactional workload box that I'm struggling with? This is the type of data that you'll be able to collect to kind of get an idea of how it will benefit you. And talking about benefit, okay, so in the example shown here, this is a buffer pool warmed up with about a terabyte of data, cache data. It's going to be about 140 million buffers. Functionally, buffer pool scans are parallelized, again, by utilizing multiple cores. So there'll be one task per 8 million buffers, where a serial scan will still be used if there's less than 8 million buffers, or 64 gigs. So for all the scenarios that were tested, we have the resulting data on the slide. It should be noted, though, that your numbers, of course, are going to vary based on the size of your machine and the workloads that are run. But we've witnessed really strong results in private testing and in lab conditions. And this is one of those features I'm so excited about. And again, customers are just going to notice SQL Server just seems faster, especially when you rely on any scenario where you're having to scan the buffer pool on a large server of a terabyte of memory or more. Okay. So promise demo, right? So let's get into that. Any questions, though, before I go start moving in?
No, I think this is awesome. I'd love to see it in action to see, like, what are the kinds of operations that I'm going to see, you know, the performance change on.
Yeah. So if we did a really, really long video, I could show you, because some of these operations can take a really long time, right? So this is the type of box that we're talking about, 2 terabytes of memory or more, right? And all those operations that we talked about before, again, you know, creating a new database, backup restore, failover events. So I want you to think about a machine like that. And so we start looking at the memory. And this is why a notebook is really helpful in this example. So I'm taking a look at the memory, and I notice that I have, for this 2 terabytes that this box has, we have 1.8 terabytes of this available memory devoted to the SQL Server buffer pool, okay? Now, and we see this here. In this next step, we're going to populate the buffers in the buffer pool by loading data from a restored database. This is the BP scan test large database that I have restored in this box. So my goal was to populate at least 64 gigs of memory. So I ran this command, and now that I have loaded this data into memory and I've verified this, I'm just looking at the SysDM OS performance counters, right? I can see that I have about a terabyte of memory that I have in the buffer pool. Okay. This is about 135 million data pages. So now that I've restored database, I've loaded these buffers into memory, I'm going to start walking through a comparison, serial versus a parallel scan. Okay. So in the examples below, right, the first example, it's just so simple, right? I'm creating a database, I'm creating a table, and I'm just loading about 100 records in. And that should be really quick, but I have this really large machine, right? So the first one is going to run in serial. I ran the next one in parallel, just using a trace flag to turn it on and off. Here's the comparison. The first one in a serial scan runs just over 10 seconds, while the parallels, the serial scan runs over just over 10 seconds. The parallel scan is just over 1 second.
Wow.
That is an improvement of almost 90%. So this is a very common scenario for customers that are constantly relying on their applications to create a net new database. How about a database per customer in like a hosted environment? You're going to want this benefit. Okay. But we have some other examples too. What about CheckDB and CheckTable, right? And you're just trying to get, just give me some relief so I can run this in a highly transactional mission critical setting. So ran CheckDB on a couple of smaller databases, ran it on that larger one. I ran CheckTable on some smaller tables. I ran this first in serial mode. I ran this again in parallel mode. Okay. We see that the benefit here is almost 30%, right? So we're going from 37 minutes to 26 minutes with 28% benefit from going from serial to parallel scan. The next one is the simulating like an always-on availability group failover event, right? So this test database, smaller database, the larger database, I'm going to set it offline and then online, first in serial mode, then in parallel mode, okay? The difference is going from 2 minutes to just under 2.5 seconds, 98%. Benefit.
That's huge.
That's huge. So customers are going to see a huge benefit on this on by default buffer pool parallel scan option. And then the last example is just, you know, one of those scenarios that just happens. I'm adding a file. I'm dropping a database, serial to parallel, exact same thing. The only difference is the trace flag that turns the option on and off. I go from 25.5 seconds to 1.6 seconds for an improvement of 93%.
Wow.
Right. So those are the comparative examples side by side, but I really quick wanted to show you some extended events. So I create this extended event. This is the stuff that we showed on the slide. I'm going to watch the live data. So I click and I say, hey, I want to watch the live data. Now, what I've done is I've taken all those examples that I previously had, Anna, and it's just noise. But I start with parallel mode, and then I'm going to run that noise again in serial mode. So first is the parallel noise, okay? Backing up, adding files, dropping files, all that stuff. Check DB, check table. Then I do it in serial mode. So to make this quick, so you can really see the difference, I did a screenshot here. In parallel mode, you see all the parallel tasks working hard through the buffer pool to make the performance much better for you. Look at the elapsed time difference when I switch over to serial mode.
Wow.
It just jumps out at you at the benefit that you get from the single feature buffer pool parallel scan. I can't wait for folks to start being able to test and use this feature in SQL Server 2022. And in the meantime, when you're in SQL Server 2016, SP3 and above, you'll be able to use some of these extended events, and you'll also be able to look for these messages like this in your error log to identify where this could potentially help you. And I'm really excited about this feature.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, I'm really excited about this feature. I think you mentioned this is going to be on by default. Is that true for SQL? Yeah. So this is another one of those great examples in SQL Server where, you know, it's just going to run faster. Things are just going to be faster because of some of the improvements. That's what I love the most about a lot of the updates we do, is that you don't have to go learn some new thing. We're just identifying something that is a pain point and fixing it. And it's just going to be faster. Right. So super exciting. Thanks so much, David, for coming on the show, showing us all these awesome examples. To our viewers, I'm sure you're going to be excited about this, have questions. Feel free to like this video, leave us a comment, follow along with the SQL Server 2022 series using the link below in the description. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.